Most of us wouldn't give earthworms a second glance, but not Emma Sherlock. Earthworms are her passion. You see, Emma is curator of worms at the Natural History Museum in London. Not only that, she's president of the Earthworm Society of Britain. As Emma is about to reveal, there's far more to the humble earthworm than first meets the eye.
Most people think we've only got one species of earthworm in the UK, but that's really not true. We actually have about 27 different species. We've got stumpy green ones, and they're bright green. Stripy ones, these ones, when they stretch out, you'll really see the stripes on them. We call them tiger worms because of the stripes. We've got pink ones, we've got grey ones, we've got ones with black heads, we've got sort of deep red ones, some are really large, sort of 30 centimetres in length, right down to some adults being just a few centimetres, so massive diversity.
Surprisingly, scientists like Emma know very little about the distribution of these different earthworm species. Sampling the worms in your garden can help fill in these gaps.
The best way to sample earthworms, really, is just to dig a hole in the ground. So I generally dig around a plot, pull out the square I've dug, and then just go through it and try and see how many earthworms are in here. And in a plot this size, potentially it could be 50, 100, maybe even if it was a really, really rich patch, maybe even up to 200 earthworms. So in an area the size of a football field, you could get maybe as many as 2 million earthworms. All gardeners know that earthworms are really, really good for the soil. But the reason that is because they are burrowing down into the soil, they're letting air in, letting carbon dioxide out. Earthworms are the recyclers of the planet. They are breaking down all the organic rubbish and releasing all those nutrients back into the soil to be used again by the plants. Without earthworms in our soils, life would pretty quickly dry up.
Earthworms aren't just good for the soil. Their juicy, muscular bodies are perfect food for lots of other wildlife. Birds just can't resist them. Badgers gorge on them. 60% of their diet is made up of worms. And moles? Well, they can eat 50 grams of worms a day. It does seem they get rather picked on by other animals.
One neat little trick I'm going to share with you is something to actually get the deep burrowing earthworms to the surface without the heavy digging. And that's this. What I've done here is mix mustard powder with water. It's maybe around 2 tablespoons per litre and a half bottle, and then pour it on the ground. What this technique does is it just irritates the worms slightly, so they come up to the surface.
Earthworm behaviour is also fascinating, not least the way they reproduce. I'll let Emma explain.
Earthworms are hermaphrodites, so that means they have male and female parts, but they still sexually reproduce. So they find another earthworm, kind of glue themselves together, pass each other sperm, and then when they've broken off, they then each produce a cocoon, which then sits in the soil until the conditions are right, and then the babies emerge. I love earthworms because they're so amazingly important for our soils. They're such fascinating animals, and when you actually start to look at them, it's amazing the diversity and variety of them, the sizes, the colours, the different jobs that they all do. And yet no one's out there looking at them. And they're working so hard under our feet. I hope you see them in a different light now.